देखो जी, आई विल टीच यू हाउ यू कैन मेन अ टाइमर फॉर इन योर एट होम इन डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टाइमर विच यू कैन यूज योर वॉशिंग मशीन सेट इट लाइक द डिजिटल वॉशिंग मशीन विच वर्क 30 वोल्ट तो नॉर्मली योर वॉशिंग मशीन वर्क और एनी टाइम यू हैव अ सर्किट लाइक अ माइक्रोवेव सर्किट विच सर्किट इफ और सम थिन इफ यू नीड टू टर्न ऑन सम थिन लोड लाइक द बल्ब और लैम्प फैन सम अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम After you can turn off automatically, so that's why you need a known as a timer. So there's analog timer, digital timer. I made a digital timer circuit. There's a timer circuit. I mean, any 5-5 timer, any 5-5 timer I see. So there are 9 volt, it was 9 volt to 12 volt. So there are 10 to a resistor and to the ground and push button. And this push button another terminal is connected to the pin number 2 of the IC. Pin number 2 of the IC. And pin number IC 6 or 7 is connected to the potentiometer, 1 mega ohm potentiometer, middle tercer terminal and third terminal. And potentiometer 1 terminal is connected to the positive line and another terminal is connected to the 1000 microfarad 16 volt capacitor to a ground. You can use 2200 microfarad 35 volt capacitor also work. If you have a 500 kilo ohm potentiometer, you should use instead of a 1 mega ohm. And then this IC pin number 5 is empty. 3 is output, which can connect buzzer and 10 ohm LED to the positive of the line. So this test I not use a buzzer, I use a LED instead of the buzzer. And pin number 1 is down, pin number 8 or 4 is connected to a positive. So 8 is positive, 4 is what? 4 is for disabling the automatically reset, because this IC have reset on built reset. I already tell you up this video. So we not need to reset IC every time. So that's where this number 4 is pulled up. So it is locked them in the one place. It will won't reset again and again. So pin number 2 and 6 are joined, which is that the 1 mega ohm to a pull up and pull down to 2000 microfarad 16 to 35 volts capacitor. And another is to 10 kilo ohm to a positive and pull down by push button and middle terminal is pin number 2. So when you spin the potentiometer, certain show is made a resistance, which resistance then slowly charge, limit the turns, how much resistance is there, you can set them, you can set them how much turn flow to this resistor, which then slowly or fastly charge this capacitor, which then I see measure between ground to the pin number 6 to measure this volt, pin number 6 or 7, combination of 6 or 7 pin of the IC and plus ground to measure the voltage across this capacitor. When capacitor voltage is to a threshold value, IC is triggered, which then turn on the buzzer output load. This case you can use the buzzer LED or something heavy load. So this IC cannot put too much current output, so you need to connect a transistor first. This transistor, PNP transistor is used, which transistor emitter is connected to the positive of the supply line and negative connected, base is connected to the output of the IC, and then connect the relay collector to the ground, and relay can switch the AC load or DC load with high current using this circuit. But this case I make a very simple, I will only turn on and off LED. So how much it takes a time to turn on an LED, I mean turn on your load and turn off the load, you can adjust by adjustable by changing this value. So if you change this value, potentiometer trim them, variable them, your output time is slow down or even time is increasing and decreasing according to your requirement if you need. But you cannot see how much time it will do now. So this is no antenna display, so you cannot monitor the time is what its time it can to be reset it or which time it can turn to be turned on. So I set this thing into a 6 volt. This is a breadboard. Drive the wires. It's connected, there are total 3 wires, 2 wires positive, negative, and LED is output for right now. I'm not 9 volt, 9.2 volt is connected. Supply. Let's see. And I am using this time because value is. I am using 500 potential meter instead of 1 ohm and 2200 microcapacitor 35 volt. I mean 25 volts, not a 35 volt. Instead of the 16 volts I was microfarad. Both ways work. Now it's, I can set this thing to the proper timing. That's the switch. Take a cell phone. Open the time. Stopwatch or timer. Let's see. I'm set a 6 minutes. So see. After a 6 minutes. Why not? We didn't hold like that. So both things can see at a time. Let's see. I've left it on the back side and see it fits. Now I explain how it works. I connect them. So basically this is webboard app. One row just I say it. Well, I think I made a webboard a full detailed video in one of my future video. I mean upcoming video in next week somewhere. Like the next Sunday. Video I can tell you, show you how it backboard is worked completely with detail or practical. Maybe we can need a time lapse. Then use this timer with help of relay. You can run them and use everything else like the heavy load. But keep in mind that relay, if you use high voltage circuit, then you can use a transistor or relay both things in them. Then connect this circuit case. Otherwise, this circuit is not powerful to power that up your equipment as well as heavy equipment as well as only relay. You cannot also run a relay directly, so you can always need a transistor to switch the relay and relay switch to your AC load or DC load also. If you run only DC load with high current load, then you cannot use a relay that transistor use with this circuit. Never that circuit is used for high current or high voltage DC circuit. DC plus AC, which was 9 volt to 16 volts. Output current is 50 to 60 milliamps. Somewhere, relay can draw 500 milliamps of current, which can fry the NE55 deadly. You can push this button for starting button. Keep in mind, push at once, not push too much time, quite of time, because this contains resistor positive to the button and button to an area you connected them. When you push the button, voltage flow to the resistor to the positive to the ground, which then resistor acts like the bridge, which the resistor is produced quite of heat also. Voltage is also dropped, which is produced also heat. Which case, if you push too long the button, push button, that case, resistor will burn out or heat. So only just one touch push and never push about more than 4 seconds. So even first second it will maybe will not start because it needs a little bit time, a little bit few seconds, like one or two seconds. So you need to push the switch continuously to nose IC to a trigger point. First self trigger. You can see it's still on 55.6 settings. Now you can see it can turn on only 15 minutes. You can see it's turned on. If you need to restart them, you can push this switch and it will do a restart. And you can adjust the time by moving this tensometer to any value. I mean, if you put anti-clockwise, I mean left side, it will, time is go lower, I mean time is increases, otherwise right side time is decreasing. So if you made a limit, a time limit, so if you need to turn on this at the maximum timing, then timing is increased to a maximum limit, which you can change the capacitor to the maximum value, capacity capacitor. If you need only 5 to 10 settings time, then you can change this capacitor with smaller value. Big time needs bigger capacity capacitor, small time capacitor. Then it's best, small capacity for small timer, small period of time. Even you can use a maximum 50 volt capacitor, minimum 16 to 50 volt capacitor you should use. Transmitter use minimum 5 kilo ohm to maximum 1 mega ohm, not much more than 1 mega ohm, not more than the million. Now then, use this circuit with any relay and any circuit. Do you like to use? And this video is end with a next video, I suppose.